When doing genetic genealogy research, sometimes you have a long list of data that you want to get from a website onto your computer. This data could be on Ancestry, GEDmatch, or any other website. Well, can this be done? Yes, yes it can. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and today we're going to be talking about tables and getting information from tables from the web. I've had users that have asked me, hey, how can I download some of this information from GEDmatch? Well, there are some places where GEDmatch actually has a button to download that information, but not always. What do you do when GEDmatch doesn't have an easy download button? Today, I'm going to show you what to do. Now, on GEDmatch, tables can come in many different varieties, but copying and downloading that information is going to be relatively similar for any of them. So here, this is from the one-to-many, the original results. And you can see here, it's just a simple table. Now, one of the things I can do is just use my mouse and highlight everything that I want. Once it's highlighted, I can do Control C to copy it. And now I'm going to put it somewhere. Start with a document, a text document. This could be in Word, Google Sheets, and just in a blank document, I can do Control V and that will paste it. And you can see here, this has actually pasted everything in that table format. And so it's really just a nice copy of what I had before. Let me go back. Now, another way I could paste it is without the formatting, or really giving it the formatting of whatever I am in. So the formatting of this text document. Now to do that, I do Control and then the Shift key and then V. Again, V for paste. Now you notice that this paste was not the same. It's not in this table format anymore, although it does look like it is delimited by a tab. So if I go from Kit to this check mark, you can see it, I just have to hit the arrow key once. So there's not spaces there, there's tabs there. And so what this does is this pastes it as a tab separated file. So I could save this and then I could open this up in a spreadsheet if I wanted. But if we're going to get it into a spreadsheet eventually, why not just paste it in a spreadsheet? So let me go over to my spreadsheet. Now again, I still have that same information and I'm going to just do the Control V in the spreadsheet and we'll see how this looks. You'll notice here that I copied from a table and when I was in the text document and I pasted it, it pasted it as a table with all the lines and everything. But in this spreadsheet, when I paste that table information, you can see that it has figured out that this is a table and put it all in the proper place. There's no lines for the table like I see in the text document, but it is still all delimited out in columns and rows like I would be expecting. And so this is a great way if you are looking at a match list in GEDmatch or one of the other tabled formats that you want to save that information and be able to manipulate it later or search through it in other ways. You can copy that all over to a spreadsheet in this manner. Now, since I showed you what copying with all the formatting does, let's look at what copying without the formatting does. So remember, Control V is a copy with the formatting. Control Shift V is copying without the formatting. So if I do that here, it almost looks the exact same. The only difference, let me copy it again, is you'll see is the copying with the formatting kept the same font size, but it also kept the hyperlinks that are there within that table. So usually you want to copy with formatting if you're copying to a spreadsheet, because you can not only save that information, but you can save the hyperlinks of where you're going to as far as other searches, other match lists. Whatever hyperlinks they have in there are going to be preserved. So here up top, this is without formatting. The nice thing about a spreadsheet is it still puts it all in where you want it. And at the bottom here is with formatting. Again, with a text document. If you copy it with formatting, you're going to get a table. And if you copy it without formatting, you're going to get it as this tabbed, eliminated file type. Now, there's more than one way to skin a cat. And there's more than one way to copy and paste table information into a file that we can use. I just went and highlighted the parts that I want. Now, let me show you one thing that is important to note on some of the other tables. This is the one-to-many, but it is the newer version. Now, you'll notice here, when I try to highlight everything, this first row, the title row, is not highlighting. But if I start down here, I can actually highlight the information. This is important to know because if you're copying a table like this, you may need to move that first line around, or you may need to put in the titles, what each column represents. So that is how you can download the table information from GEDmatch onto a spreadsheet and be able to manipulate it however you need to in order to do the research that you have. Now, if you like this video, then be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to join FHF Extra, we have more webinars and live streams that are available just to members each month, as well as all of our backlog of the members only section.